Greetings, warriors. Good morning. Welcome to Morning Talk. Hope you guys are doing well, having a great day, staying on your journey. I appreciate all the comments and feedbacks and things that we've gotten. And also one of the things I've gotten some feedback with, and I appreciate the comments on this, is the name of the show. And we're going to go ahead and kind of think about this more. We have some people who want to keep it the Morning Talk, Retention Talk, and then some people want to kind of think about inspiration and other types of titles. So I appreciate all the great comments on that, and we're going to go ahead and kind of keep thinking about that and seeing where we go with that. But once again, thank you for all the comments, and I appreciate all the efforts you guys make and spending time out of your busy day to kind of, you know, contact me and things like that. So I appreciate that. Also, let me shout out to a bunch of different people sending things, topics and everything. Today we're going to talk about flatlining and headaches. So NeonAirmaxes95, thank you for that. Alberto's got a question on financial advice, and I'll tackle that a little bit tomorrow. We have a bunch of people: Patriot Gaines, Felipe, Wretched, Sofish, Willingness, Araco, Jeju, and Jay wanted me to talk about Brahmacharya a little bit, so I'm going to do that in one of these sessions coming up. Baba's got one on monk mode, so we're going to talk about that a little bit as well. He's got a good question on that one. And then we had a few other ones last night. C. Sal talking about feminine and masculine men and why and being subservient and those type of things. So we're going to tackle that one down the line. And then eye contact, I'm going to go back to him a little, because Nasir had a good point and question about that as well, and how strong eye contact is when it comes to exerting your energy out there. Also, shout outs to Alberto, Limitless Vision. Thank you for your comments and those type of things too. And there's other one I'm going to tackle at some point, is why are there so many single men now out there than there used to be? And there's a lot more of them than there used to be. So very interesting type of topics. All right. So anyway, today's topic we're going to talk about, and please go ahead, subscribe, like, comment as we do this. I appreciate everything you guys are doing. Flat lines and headaches. So NeonAirmaxes95. Thank you for that comment and question. Good question. So when we talk about flatlining and we're talking about headaches, let me take the headaches first. Well, actually, you can probably take them both together in some ways. The key, in my opinion, this is just my opinion, I don't have any kind of scientific proof to back this up, but I'm just kind of throwing some ideas out there on this. In my thoughts, what happened to me was that, and I always refer to this time before I started doing this kind of stuff. And so I refer to my ages 12 and 13 years old, back when I was a young teenager. And yes, I guess I could say I was a little more secure because I had my family, and I didn't have to pay bills and all that kind of stuff. I was still just going through school. I think it was in 7th, 8th grade or something like that, and around those type of periods. And so all that kind of stuff, I don't remember a lot of those type of things. I do remember individual types of things. But I also remember having a different level of feeling inside. And I can't tell you what that feeling is, except just more serenity or peace. You know, I wasn't anxious and having those type of attitudes. And I thought, because I was a kid and because I wasn't really responsible for anything at that point, that probably was just, a factor of that. But as I now look at the last 45 years before I started this journey, I realized that there's a big difference. And once I started doing a lot of these things, and I couldn't stop doing this, I went back and forth and things like that, I noticed a big difference, especially now that I'm near 600 days, and I now realize that this is all really a lifestyle change. And now I'm feeling more like I did before those days, where even though I have a girl, a woman flirting with me, it's not, I don't really pay attention to it like I used to. It's not like any lustful thought or anything like that. It's really more of a case that I'm more balanced. And so because of that, my body has changed. And so almost like let me give you an example of caffeine addiction, or if you're dehydrated. Your body is trying to get used to the different state you're in. And because of that, you're feeling different. And all of a sudden, I get headaches, especially if I get dehydrated. So I may suggest that if it's not really dealing with retention, if you're getting the headaches, I definitely would think about, especially in this type of season we're having right now, you know, making sure you're hydrated. The other thing I would suggest is definitely just kind of focusing on realizing your body is changing. And especially if you're going through a few weeks or a month or so, I used to get some of those type of headaches as well because of that, because my system was used to so many years of a different type of attitude and thought pattern. So I definitely would look at things like, you know, hydration first, but I also would look at trying to make sure that you just stay on your pace, and eventually those things should be going away if it's more of a retention thing than anything else. But once again, your body is getting back to full strength. This is kind of how I look at it. It's almost like a glass, an empty glass. You know, if you're emptying all your energy out, eventually if you stop doing that, now your body has to react to all this energy. And you could get overloaded at times. And that's why you have to get involved in activities and doing things in which you're using your energy constructively to let that out. So you're not going to end up getting overloaded and stressed out and things like that. So this is what happens, especially when you're younger. You have so much of that energy inside of you that, you know, people sometimes think they're going to explode. And this is why you got to get yourself involved in activities and things so that you can use this energy to go ahead and really make a difference. But not only that, but to not be overloaded, transmute that energy. See, keeping that energy inside is going to be like a nuclear bomb waiting to explode. There's no doubt about that. But this is why the second part of this is to transfer that energy. Now, flatlining. Again, this goes back to the same type of thing, thinking-wise. If your body is so used to being empty, the body adapts to that. Just almost like eating. If I'm eating for 2 years in a row every day, and all of a sudden I go on a fast for 3 or 4 days, my body has trouble with that. In fact, I'll get headaches as well because I'm fasting. Because all of a sudden the body's trying to respond to something different. Not having the food, not having that, and it goes in kind of protective survival panic mode. And that's why at some point, if you stop doing fasting, you're not going to end up losing any more weight because your metabolism will balance itself out. And it goes much slower. And that's why you have to exercise along with fasting or, you know, not eating to end up losing weight. Because eventually your body will balance itself out. And the same thing with it goes retention, same kind of principle, in my opinion at least, that you're going to be able to balance yourself out. So that means flatlining is something that's going to be happening to all of us. You won't notice the difference. Not that they are not there. I mean, I noticed, like, for instance, focus is still wonderful. You know, the focus is great. I noticed that the positive attention from people, females especially, is still off the charts. But my perspective has changed. Now that I appreciate those things a lot more, and I know they're there, my perspective is different as well. So flatlining is really more of a case of perspectives as well, that you're expecting things to be a certain way, and so in your mind, it's not really increasing or decreasing. Now, if you would go ahead and relapse, those of you do, realize the difference. Now, I wouldn't recommend that, of course. You know, try to stay as long as you can on your journey. But those who have relapsed, and I did it for many years, you realize the differences between the two. Now, you have to be strong enough. Now, in my mind right at this moment, I have no need to do any of that kind of stuff. So my whole perspective is on goals, you know, and working. I work 65 hours a week, and I love what I'm doing and teaching, tutoring, and helping young people and all kinds of stuff and teaching many classes, consulting, things like that. So I enjoy doing all the things I'm doing at my age, and I could do them all day long. But that means I'm also transmitting and using energy so that I can get those things done as well. And so I think that's a key component of all this, trying to make yourself feel useful and purposeful. That's why I always say, are you on your purpose? And I'm not just talking about your journey on retention. I'm talking about, are you using that energy to make a difference in this world? And I think that's a key thing, because in my mind, we are all blessed to be part of this 1% club who understands and recognizes this real truth. Whether you study brahmacharya, celibacy, sophism, you're all blessed to have this knowledge. And I feel very blessed that I've learned this knowledge. But there's a reason in my mind that God puts certain people in that role. And I think I was, before I started this journey, I was really scared to go on and talk about this because of ramifications that were in my mind more than anything else. But the key to me is to try to get these ideas out. And whether you believe it or not, you know, that's going to be up to you. But what I want to do is at least share those, because I can share my experiences, because I've been there in a lot of these type of cases. You know, I lived back in the late 60s as a young kid, and then a teenager in the early 70s, and I've seen all the drugs and open sex and all kinds of stuff that I saw. You know, so I've seen a lot of things, you know, gang-related type in my life, things like that. So I've been experienced a lot of different things, and I could tell you at this moment in time, I feel really the best that I've ever felt. And that's because I believe that I'm getting closer to God, in my opinion, you know, with this retention. And as a result of that, you're going to see flatlining, but you're going to see peace, tranquility, which means it's just by nature is going to be flatlined, because you're not going to have the high and lows. You're not going to have the drama in your life. You have to be prepared for that, by the way. You're not going to have the drama. You're going to take things very calmly most of the time. You're not going to have the anger. You're not going to have that, because your emotions are in check because of all the nutrients and energy that you're keeping in your body. You're not going to need to fly off the handle. You're not going to need these type of things. You're not going to get upset with people. Okay? This is one of the benefits of the whole thing, is the fact it's going to make you very calm most of the time. Yes, of course, you're going to, at times, may stray away from that. But focusing on life instead of focusing on men or women, if you're a woman, a man, if you're a man, a woman, instead of focusing on all those other things as your identity or your everything in life, I have to sleep with as many people as I can. That's just a real, it's a way that I will remove myself from. I'm not going to, no longer near that end. And I can't tell you how happy I feel that I don't need to do that stuff anymore, because that just wasn't me. So, all right, guys. So I hope this helps, NeonAirmaxes95. I hope I answered your question. If not, you know, please send me another message, and I'm happy to try to focus on another aspect of it. But I think that one of the things to get used to is the fact that you're going to have some body changes, and you're going to have some things that look like nothing's happening, but inside of you everything's happened. And so when you get to the point where you keep moving along on this journey, your body's going to adapt and change for the better and make you a more successful person. So sometimes it will look like it's going to flatline, and sometimes you will have headaches and different types of things because your body is withdrawing from all that nasty type ideas and thoughts that we had before. All right, my friends, hope you guys have a great day. Once again, this is January, I didn't even say the date. This is January 21st, 2022. And battle on, warriors, battle on.